All right. Here we are with this bull crap. I don't know what I'm doing here. I decided to make a front lawn for the Reaper School. That way, you know, if you come this way, you leave the area and then you're at the world map. And I was thinking about putting like a forest that you could go into over here. Like a little on-campus dungeon. Dungeony. Donjons. Okay. So I'd like to do a couple of things. I'd like to go through some more skills, just because I think that I get a lot done. We don't have to do... We can do some action sequence stuff tonight, but for the most part, I just want to get them done, you know? I just want to get them out there. By the way, I finished off this stuff. So, Nature Blast. I was like, I don't have to make it all special, you know? I don't have to make it super duper special. Just a blast of nature damage to all enemies based on magic. Instant with a cooldown of 3. You know, it's not special, but, you know. And I decided to go ahead and do meditate. I might edit it at some other point, but for now, this is what I got, right? As, for 3 turns, you can't move, but you recover 5% of your SP, and you can be hit out of it. That way, the 5% is so that it scales if you have, you know, if you've fed them a lot of SP fruits. But, you know, there's, just in case, right? Like, if we think about it realistically, 5% is for anyone with 30 SP, which I think is around the upper limit that I've given SP people. Maybe 35 for specific characters, I don't remember. But that's basically, like, you know, 1 SP every 3 turns. It's not great. It technically would be like 1.5, but the decimals aren't added. And actually, I don't know if it would round up or down. But anyway. What else did I do? I think I did something off camera, but I don't remember what it was. I haven't made this yet, but I know that I want it to be some kind of something like that. I did something. Oh, I made the jump ability off screen. By, you know, it's pretty easy to do whenever you just copy paste it. But you can get that from the Dragon Lance. Dragon Slayer Lance? I don't remember. I remember what it was called. I do have somebody that I haven't made anything for. Which is another buddy of mine. He's a guy that I go to for music most of the time. And I don't hang out with him as much as I should. And technically it's been a couple of years since we've hung out, but he does good music, and I offered him to have a character in here, and I should, maybe let's make a, I'm pretty sure he kind of gave me free run over kind of what he does. Staff and rune sort of guy. Maybe some sort of vine whip thing he can conjure. To be clear, this guy's very magical. The stuff he does with his plants is magic based. I did remember that he was glassy. Not get glassy. Grassy. Planty based. Fungus-based mayhem. Plant and fungus-based mayhem. I think I could do something like that. Bread and butter. Bread and butter. That's the first thing that comes to mind whenever it comes to mushrooms. Is there no mushroom in here? There's no mushroom. Boo. I'm not seeing a mushroom anymore. Wait! Boom. Spore. Mushroom. Okay. I think it should be all enemies. Spore them. But would that be nature or blight? Right? I kind of think of, like, I know this is kind of probably a little bit weird, but
I kind of think of plants and fungi as like different categories of, let's just say, damage. So if we were to put them into like a different category of, instead of, you know, the types that I've made, like plants could be like earth, and I would say that mushrooms would be more like necrotic. I don't know if the D&D necrotic would be the best way of explaining it, but it's more like decay, you know? Does that make sense? Decay? And that's kind of where blight was going, you know, in so I do think that blight kind of matches fungi a little bit more. Yes, of course, can critical hit. Having an idea here. I'm having a little bit of an idea. As I said before, I'm thinking about getting rid of the drunkenness. Stuff. So, yeah, I'm gonna do it. I'm doing it. I'm getting rid of the drunk stuff. Just because I don't want it, you know? I don't want it anymore. So there, it's done. And then get rid of the drunk. I made 10 things of buzzed. It sucks. I'm getting it out of here. Now, I have an idea. However, I have to open up another project in order to get it because I'm lazy and I've already made it somewhere else. Now, I'm going to change it around a little bit, but my poison in Happily Ever After is a little mean. So I'm probably going to change it up just a tad. But all in all, spore. We're going to have a 5-level ability, or state, I should say. that gradually gets worse the longer that it's left alone. Now the difference here, you know, maybe somebody else could be able to inflict spore, but for the most part, I'm gonna leave it as is. And that should be turn. I don't know why that's action. Oh, I think I made it action because I wanted it to be like, what's the word? I wanted it to get worse if you moved around, but wouldn't get worse if you didn't do anything. Or something like that. Let's just say over time. Or have it remove at the end of battle. In case it gets reflected somehow. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna be an a-hole. And I'm not gonna make it remove at the end of battle. Only one character in the entire game has the ability to do this to people. So if they get reflected in it, all right, but what do we want our spore to do? So my poison in Happily Ever After has 5 stages, as I said before. The first one, just minus 20% hit rate. You know, you're getting a little bit of a fever. Everything's getting a little blurry, hard to see. And then you keep the hit rate minus 20%. It doesn't get any worse. But you also gain oh, yeah, hold on. That's what it was. I need to make it. I remember what that was now. You're getting sluggish, you know? And then the resisting the spore one is so that you can't be, so that it doesn't stack, you know? And since nothing is ever going to inflict spore 2 through 5, you have to be inflicted with spore 1. It's a, you know, it's just, it's fine to have them resist spore 1. Anyway, so vision's getting a little blurry, your fever's starting to act up, and then you, stage 1, stage 2, vision's still blurry, sluggish, so your evasion rate goes down. Then you heal less. Your healing done to you is 50% less effective. And then MP cost of all of your, excuse me, of all of your skills and magic and everything is increased by 30%. Because you're, it's just too hard, you know? And then finally, your max HP is cut in half. And that's how my poison works in Happily Ever After. Now, I'm going to edit this a little bit after I do. I'm going to try to do push-ups. I'm going to try them. I think it'll be fun.
So 10 push-ups.
Why does she need 200?
She's gonna go. She's always going low on her prices. She always comes back without the things that I want.
So you don't think that 150 will do it?
I don't. Alright. So I just added 12 back to prices.
Then, sure, she can have 200.
She used the rest of it on bills.
Yeah. Okay, well. Great. It's awesome. So yeah, I have each one to last 5 turns before they turn into the next version, and then stopping at Spore 5, or Poison 5. And I don't really have the ability to show anything on the icon, which is excuse me, a little sad, but actually, hold on, I think I have an idea. I'm gonna do something stupid real quick. Open folder. I have an idea here. I'm gonna make an animation real quick. It's probably not gonna go very well, but I'm gonna do my best. I'll wait. I'll wait until it's done. Alright. So, I don't know the... I don't know the sides for these, or the sizes for animations. Totally just blanked on what I was doing. I doubt that it's 48 by 48. Hold on, let's see if there's a contents. So bright. Yes. What's the problem? So she took 300?
300. Tomorrow she's going to put $100 back in.
Okay.
That way she don't panic. You know what's going on. There's no freaking out. She's panicking. Freaking out.
Mm-hmm.
So just wait till tomorrow. It'll be
Okay.
She was just like, what did I do?
It's fine. It's fine. It's all good. Okay, this is primarily the image of animation to battle screen. One cell contains an image that measures 192 by 192 in size. Okay, so this is 192 by 192. That's what I was looking for. Okay, so this is blow. Well, no offense, blow, but you're about to become spore. I just needed the size. I just needed the size. Dang it. I'm pressing the wrong hotkey. Need to rotate. All right, copy. And we'll paste that one. Now we're gonna copy that. I'm gonna paste it. And come over here. Boom. Yes. I don't know if I wanna like flip that upside down or not, or just leave it as is. All right. Okay, I don't know if this will... You know, technically, I didn't have to do this. Now that I'm thinking about it, I only needed the one. Oh, I'm stupid. So that means, hold on, let me see if I can make a... another one. Out of some tiles. Another animation something out of some tiles or something. Nah. So yeah, I technically didn't need this. So I'm just gonna do that. That way I can... export as... Spore. Discard those changes. Ugh, it's so bright. Okay. Now we're gonna come down here. For animations. And really, technically, I only need the one frame. Then I can change the colors here if I want. Oh my god, dude. Why are you always in additive? Normal. We'll scale it by a little bit. Put that at the basic 00. Let's change the target. Okay, if it was to be on a person, be right there in the middle. Put it right there. You know what? I'll do a little bit more. There's an easier way of doing that, so we'll copy, paste it. That's at -68. So, make -68. We'll scale it like that. And then we'll tween frames 1 through 5. -68, boom, And then between frames 5 through 10. Why does it move, though? Oh. That's weird. I must have had it over on accident. Now it'll grow and pulsate. And then repeat. Spore state 2. Keep rotating it. Yeah, keep rotating a little moment. Minus 50, minus 40. Minus 40. And we just keep doing it, you know? Between 1 through 5, boom. And then between 5 through 10. There we go. And since this is just a state, no, don't mirror then. This will be plus 45. Why did I even do that? I could have just typed it. Was it 40, 60? Negative 40. Okay. Between 1 through 5. Negative 40, and then tween 5 through 10. Boom, grows and shrinks, grows and shrinks. Then for spore 4, what do you say we keep it the same but change the hue? To like a purple. And then spore 5. Will be back to 1. But is 200% the size? No. Not good enough. 300% the size. Zero, negative 68. I forgot what it was. Zero, negative 68. And it grows 50% more. I'm gonna keep the first one the same. I'm not gonna keep the evasion rate the same, though, because I kind of had an idea that the state rate now you go ahead and tell me if this doesn't seem like it would work too well, but for some reason I was thinking that it would make inflicting bleed easier. Also, now that I'm here, I'm going to do something that I keep forgetting to do. Where is it? Where are you? Where's the restoration? Stacking region, that's what I was gonna look for. So the fact that poison can stack up to 10 times for 3 damage each poison stack, equaling 30, and bleed can stack indefinitely for as many as you can put on them. But the regenerate effect can only counter so much. So I decided, where's the maximum amount of stacks to 10, right? Yes, I'm going to change that to actually be, I don't know if I want to do 15, that'd only be 45. I'll do it to 20. So you can have a stacks of 20. If you get it there, you know. You know, that way, if you have enough, then you can completely negate poison, but if you have more, you can still gain a benefit from it to offset any bleed that the character might have. Sure. Sure, that'll be good for views. Me eating a banana. Oh, that banana. Time to eat a banana on the internet. Maybe I will. I mean, the evasion rate kind of works with Spore, too, you know? The one thing that I'm not going to do, definitely, I'm not going to do the minus 50% HP. You know what? I think I'm gonna leave it the way it is. But on Spore 5, if it lasts this long, you know. I'm gonna take a thing that I got down here. Oh god, I downloaded Notepad Plus and then went to bed without actually downloading it, or without actually installing it. Okay, so. I'll be right back. Okay, so the way that I want this to go, with this part in particular, is I want this to be incredibly useful in longer battles, right? It's the only way you're going to get them this far, a lot of times. But that also makes me want to change the MP cost rate. Thing to I'm gonna change the MP cost rate. I had this weird idea, another weird idea, that it would change their attack element to blight. So their basic attack normal attack element. I'm just gonna do that anyway. And also, Leech SP. Absorb. I have an idea. I don't know how good it would look, though. You know? Okay. I can't highlight them all. All right. Frame 5. Wait. Frame 1 through 5. I really don't know how to use batch. Gonna do this way, since I don't know how to use this properly. Hold on. Oh, that's why I'm an idiot. Change that to that. Change that to that. And yes. No, thank you. Copy, paste, 0, screen, and we'll actually reduce it by, let's say, 20%. Good, Bruhark! How are you today? I'm just fine, thank you for asking. gonna tween 9 through 15. I'm glad to hear you're doing grand. I'm making a thing. And then over 3 more. Jeez. I like to use the clicker. And then from 15 to 17. Multiply. Supposed to be normal. Why are you on multiply? You're supposed to be on normal. Okay, I think I get it. It's because I put it on screen on this one. So it blended it through multiply to screen. And then starting from here, paste that one there. We'll get rid of that one because we don't need it anymore. We will change the pattern. And then we slowly move it down. I'm making a something, if that wasn't obvious. So I'll let it go to the feet. So the thing that I'm making is, I made a buddy of mine, has a character in here and we haven't done anything for him. So I just kind of figured that we'd, you know, do something for that character. We're, so I'm making, his first, what's it called? His first skill, is a, called Spore. And wait, that's 26. His first ability is called Spore. And I'm basing it off of a poison ability that I made. Or not a poison ability, but the poison state that I made for Happily Ever After. Shut up! I'm trying to say something! Which... Yeah. Which is a state that progressively gets worse the longer you have it. So for every 5 turns, it gets harder on whoever's inflicted with it. So that's why I have Spore State 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the final one is Leech SP. Because in this, I've edited it a little bit. The first 3 are the same as in Happily Ever After, but the 4th one changes their attack element to Blight, and the 5th version basically Leech Seeds MP, or SP, by 5 at a time. And so I was making an animation for the actual leeching of the SP. Need to do sit-ups. I'll be right back. So anyway, yeah, it's most of the time Spore will not get to level 5. Since it takes 5 turns for each, it'll be for really long drawn out battles, but the effects just keep on getting better. Although certain bosses will probably have some kind of way of removing status ailments in between phases or something. So it really depends, but Spore could be useful for multiple phases depending on how long the fights take. Or at least that's the recovery effect. Minus 50% on at level 3 is a little much now that I think about it. So I'm going to increase that to only a 25% reduction. There you go, yeah. I actually don't even know if this would work. But should be fun. Gotta find the No, that's not it. Not that either. Oh, come on, I'm looking. Chuckle spores. I'm looking for something kind of... I wanted something sparkly. Yeah, that's what I was looking for. See? That's all I needed. Yeah! All right, now. Play 136. Whoop. Okay. Now, I don't actually know if that'll work. Oh, I know what else I could do. I could show you my progress. It still needs a little work, but I could show you my progress on that action sequence that we were working on. Once I, also, I downloaded Notepad Plus, but I, while it was downloading, I went to sleep and forgot to actually install it. Funny enough. So maybe we'll do that real quick. No, not attack. Dang it. So this is what it looks like now. Still needs a little bit of tweaking. But as you can see, putting the colons after the weight helped out immensely. Also, there's a little bit of goofiness with auras in this. And you'll be able to see it whenever he starts jumping. I have no clue. Why that does that. And I have no clue how I would fix it. Whatever, you know, whatever. It's fine.
It's fine. When is that ever gonna come up?
I'll wait until people are playing the game and then they see it and then they can be like, oh, well, I'm actually an RPG maker developer too. I know how he could fix that. And I will watch every single Let's Play of my game and take all of their ideas. Anyway. I actually had this thought earlier that Spore, his character is another plant-based mage, which I think is kind of cool that there's more than one. We could call him a druid if you want. He's more of a mushroomy guy and can make plants grow out of the ground, grab people and stuff. I like that. I like that. I would do that. Yeah. But to the question, I've always thought of mushroominess as completely separate from plant damage, you know? So if you were to call plants earth damage or something, or like if you're a Chinese RPG wood element or something like that, mushrooms would be under like the necrotic category of like decay instead of plants. I know that plants and fungi are different, but they're not, though. You know? Like, everything is different, but they're not, though. But I put it under blight. And I figured I would ask for a couple of other opinions before I just left it there. Right, but blight is like the all-around like decay element in this. It's like necrotic in D&D. So, you know what? I'm leaving it. And very few other things will be able to inflict spore, and they'll mostly be enemies, and he's the only character that you can recruit that can inflict spore. So basic attack. Oh, also, I don't know if I said this out loud, but I actually went through all of these and I changed the numbers of the damage formula. I boosted it by a little bit for everyone, everything. So, you know, MAT times 1.5 instead of 1.25. I'm gonna have it against basic defense because it's a magical hit, but it's a like a physical magical hit, you know what I mean? All right. Ooh, that was a big one. Excuse me. Sorry for all that. My brain was so rattled by it. Like I got a dizzy spell from that. Ugh. Whew, that's nuts. Alright. And one enemy. Three MP cost. There's, again, stealing from Yawnfly's tips and tricks, there's a skill that I've been wanting to put in here, but I haven't had a character for it. I think I could give it to him. There's a tips and tricks teaching you how to make this ability. It's from another game called, I think it was Tree of Savior, from the Linker class. And basically you just link things together, and whenever they take damage or are healed, it is split between them instead of being towards one of them, so they'll take half the damage, but the other character will take half the damage too. And you can use it either offensively or defensively. And in Joey's game, The Moan Patrol, the porn game that I went a little overboard with the combat mechanics, because he was like, it's just a porn game, what are you doing? Why are you making it so crazy? I was like, it needs to be fun first! But I actually made it a boomerang ability. So the way that the game works is you can equip two weapons, and each... all of your skills are weapon-based, so... and you don't learn the skills. And you have room to equip spell books, and that's how you get your magic spells. But I made, like, 60 weapons, all with different abilities. All with different... skills and stuff. Usually only one each, but I think some of them had like two. But anyway, boomerangs in true RPG fashion hit all enemies once whenever you use your basic attack with them. So I made that happen, and I also made the, I don't remember what I was called. I think it was just like the Link Boomerang or something like that. I think there was a better name for it. Which, whenever you use its skill, it goes through all enemies, like normal, and links them all together. And I noticed an unintended side effect... that basically made boomerangs way more OP on accident. And that was whenever they were all linked together like that, and then you'd throw your boomerang, it wouldn't split the damage, it would quadruple it. So if there were four enemies and it went through all four of them, it would hit and split the damage for that one, but it would wind up hitting the next one, and then it would actually add up to be more than the original hit would have done. It was accidentally. I didn't know that would happen. So I accidentally, and yes, I do mean accidentally, made the boomerangs the most powerful weapons with that one ability to link everything together and quadruple the damage on everything. And it actually would, it was a compounding effect, so the more enemies that it would go through and the more enemies that were linked, the more everyone would take. And even with lower stats in testing, it would still wind up like one-shotting parties that you couldn't kill with one hit. But yeah, it was a fun little side story. But the reason I bring that up, because I'm so scatterbrained, is because I'm thinking that we could have some like link vines. You know? And I don't know if I would make it all enemies. Or if I'd even make it enemies at all, because you could link, you know, your characters together. Link the party members together and be like, all right, I'm gonna share some of the damage for you. I also don't know if I would be able to make it to where you could choose two different ones, or if it would always have to be you and one other, or I don't know. I'd have to look at that. I'm just gonna put link vines right here, and then we can move that around and do something with it. Okay, so let me read the text from a couple weeks ago again. Or maybe it'd be like link two random allies together. Or you could link allies with enemies, and then anytime the ally takes damage, the other one, the enemy takes damage. Okay, so this, he even sent me a picture. I think that's a Tiny Tina's Wonderland character as a reference. This guy is remembered for being weird and unsociable and is mostly known for spending too much time with his plants. He looks like he's sniffed his mushrooms a few too many times, but nobody really knows much about him. It's all rumors and hearsay. Destiny Bond. But get him into battle, and he will unleash plant and fungus-based mayhem on everything. Obviously, you don't want him to be OP, but he should be a force to be reckoned with. So I kind of rolled with the fungus immediately. Seems like a staff and rune sort of guy. Maybe some sort of vine whip that you can conjure. To be clear, this guy is very magical. And the stuff he does with his plants is magic-based. So we're talking plants coming out the ground to grab people and so on. Yes. Yes, okay. Alright. He wants plant and fungus-based mayhem. So, Spore is a pretty good debuff, since it just keeps on getting worse and worse every 5 turns. Oh, also, I need to actually try out the, whatchacallit. I need to make sure it works. Yeah, no? Oh, hold on. Not you, no. Get out of here. Get out of here with that. I've been using you to test stuff. So we're gonna test out that animation real quick. And test out to see if the SP recovery thing works. All right, nice. Okay, so now I should have reduced the turns that were needed for it to change. So yeah, I made pulsating mushrooms. And as it changes, they grow more mushrooms. I needed to make sure that all of them worked properly. So, I guess it's fine that I'm taking a small little time out here to guard 45 times. Or actually 44 times, because the first time I had to actually use Spore. Yay! It works! And then they turn purple for stage 4. And then stage 5. Stage 5. That was preemptive. Stage 5. I lost count. Stage 5. I lost count. Stage 5. They merge together and become giant shroom. And now we see if the MP is suck. MP did not suck. Ah, I know exactly why. I know exactly why MP did not suck. Because the origin of Spore 5 was the leave effect of Spore 4. Therefore, it has no origin. So it cannot suck and leech. SP. Okay, time to do more push-ups. I was able to do 10 earlier, so I'm gonna try to do 10 again. Okay, so that doesn't work. So level 5 spore is gonna have to be changed to something else. Unless we can figure out a way to make this work. Actually, I might be able to fix this. I would just have to figure out how to do actors, you know, since it's going to be actor 23. I could just be like, if actor 23 alive instead of origin. Since the only way that you could do that is to have him in your party, you know. It's never gonna... Vindergrass. So I would just have to learn how to call that specifically up. I don't know how, though. I've never done that before. If actor 23... I wish I was able to do that. Just actor 23. Okay, I'm gonna leave it as is, and then mess with that off camera, too. So anything that's gonna stop my progress, I'm gonna leave it for later. Alright. Do we want to do some hammer skills? Let's try to do a couple of hammer skills. Maybe real fast. Let's bang them out. And then we'll maybe try to do some work on this map that I started but never finished. And, fun, tomorrow, me and Joey are gonna start talks about the first battle sprite sheet. I'm scared. Anyway, it's not necessarily actually a hammer, but I put batons in here. And the first one that you get is just like a police baton. So, let's see. What could we do for a baton? Maybe a defensive move? Or we could go to one that I already have Sunder, which is it's basically disarm, but reduces defense instead. And charge is for the rocket hammer. And I was thinking about some kind of like stacking crit chance. So the more times you use it, the higher your crit chance gets. Maybe. I don't know. That's just where my original thought was going with that one. My brain has stopped again. Batons are used in aiding arm locks. Ooh. I kind of like the thought of that. Arm lock? My immediate thought is something I've already done, though. Which is clamp. Except for the difference would be that neither character would be able to move. But the character in question would take a little bit of damage equal to the user's equal to the user's blah. U.S. The Office of Justice Program states that, with the exception of the jab, all blows should be short and snappy. Short and snappy. Snappy strike. I do like snappy. Snappity. Snappy strike. Mm-hmm. We already have a quick slash, which is... basically just a speed-based instant ability. Snappy blows could be delivered quickly and accurately and are difficult to block or parry. Ah, a multi-hit! Okay. Low damage, quick strikes. A.ATK. Times, let's see. .85. And let's go with 75, since there's gonna be... what you think? 3? Maybe? Multi-hit that partially negates defense or bypasses parry? Don't know how easy it would be to do that. I can do that pretty easily, actually. Especially the ignoring counterattack chance. And not to mention, all hammers have a small stun chance built into them. So the baton just straight has, it's very small for most of them. So it's only like a 3% stun chance, but the rocket hammer has a higher percent because, you know, it's got a rocket engine. But 3 hits also has a chance to... I'm going to leave the full defense, right? So it might not even do any damage. But the bypassing... bypassing counter is easy. Especially because thank you, Yawnfly, once again. Boom. Skill item makes this action unable to proc counter skills by allied members. Cannot counter. And now it is uncounterable. I like it. It's simple. To the point. You know? However, I am not making it instant. I know they're snappy, but I gotta draw the line somewhere. I had a 3-hit combo that can be instant. Backswing. An excellent procedure for using this type of blow would be to feint a short swing to the opponent's head and strike a backswing blow to his left or right knee. Ooh. Ooh, I put an S in there instead of a D. cannot be countered. Never thought this hard about hitting someone with a glorified stick. It's collapsible. The butt stroke? Is that what that says? This blow is generally delivered upward or sideward using that portion of the handle below the right handle or the butt of the baton to strike the opponent.
The butt stroke. I like it.
Probably not going to be used in another one, but not enemies. All right, claw hammer. A basic carpenter's hammer. Well, that one's pretty easy too, right? It's like rake. You just turn it around and hit with the other side, and you got a bleed move. If we're going simple, you know? Move along techniques. These are techniques which can be used to move an individual a short distance while maintaining a certain amount of control over him. 1. Note. Between the legs. There are two variations of this technique, and both are effective in moving an individual a short distance. A. Grab opponent's left elbow with your left hand as you push the barrel of the baton between his legs. Baton handle should be outside opponent's left leg. Just grind that baton against the dude's junk. I mean, they're gonna move with you. If you're trying to move someone, they're gonna move. I don't want it to be so specific. The second one is worse. I don't want it to be so specific like rake, though, you know? Like, snappy strike is not specific. Sunder, not specific. Charge is technically not specific, even though you get it from a rocket hammer, which could possibly be, you know, make you understand why it's charging. They have you shove your arm between their legs with the baton held to make a T in front of their hips. That doesn't sound very... like, that would be very good. Might have them, like, fold over the baton. Grasp the middle of the baton with your right hand using thong in same manner as for the long grip. Insert the baton between the opponent's legs as you grab his clothing at the neck with your left hand. Move the opponent forward by raising your right arm against his groin as you lift and push him by the neck. Oh, so you are trying to knock him over. I thought you were just trying to, like, use it as a handle to pull him. Like a little wagon handle. Oh, you're using it to escort a prisoner. Maybe get a little grab while you're down there. Bleeding. To bleed. To make bleed. To make bleed. Scrape? No. Doesn't work with a hammer. Bleed. I think I'm stuck. I'm stuck in a pigeonhole. Claw hammer. What kind of special ability could a claw hammer do? Yeah, what kind of special skill could you learn from wielding a claw hammer that could be used with any other hammer? Anatomy? That's not a skill.
Where to claw people?
Yes.
In the jugular and such. Femoral things.
Okay. Wait, why did I give the claw hammer counterattack chance? Visceral strike. Strangles the baton can be used quite effectively in strangling an opponent who has either gone berserk or is extremely violent. Choke a bitch. Visceral strike. It is very violent. I'm gonna be normal all the time. If it's just a starter weapon, we could go with Bop. Just a little boop on the noggin. The starter weapon is actually the baton. I guess I could switch them around a little bit. I could switch the claw hammer and the baton. And I'm taking those ideas and just trying to decide which would make things easier for me. Yeah, you know what? cancel. Oh no. Okay, cool. I didn't mean to do that. Paste. Boom. Ooh. That's a big old red strawberry. Ooh. I don't know. Look how pretty that is. I'm so easily amused whenever it comes to colors, man. Chance of stun here. Basic damage, basic attack damage. And this could also be basic, right? With a 70% stun chance. No. It's too simple. It can be simple, but that's too simple. Hold on. Soldiers and clerics. Cleric stance. Oh, and I also got rid of the drunk stuff. I just decided I didn't care. Like, I left the drinks in as they were, but I just didn't care about the drunk bullcrap anymore. Offensive stance. Hmm. We're gonna edit that. That's gonna be magic defense. While your attack suffers. Ten more squats.
Can do, Mr. Alarm.
Save it. What would you say about just changing your basic attack damage to divine in cleric stance? A little bit too... Nah, that's too... If anybody could do that. Like, I want there to be a third benefit. Or a third thing. A second benefit. I know I can't be have every move be convoluted. That's, I just, you know, I want them to be even. And that's not very convoluted. It's just, I'm struggling to think of even basic things now. So now instead of doing anything that says normal attack, we'll... Attack, normal attack. And I want there to be stances for every weapon, you know? Boom. Self. Battle screen. I think I forgot to change, make it to where it doesn't. Yep, remove at the end of battle. Bam! And then I'll just come up here. Copy and paste that. Stance. Actually, it'd probably be easier to do it from here. wisdom. That's 15% strength. Attack element divine. Does that make sense, right? And now I actually have to check something real quick, because I just thought of something. Okay, so renew removes all states that a character is afflicted with and heals based on the amount. Costs 2 MP for the user. Costs 2 MP and has no cooldown. But also is not instant. All right. I would probably, if I ever change the attack element, What about this? Changes to divine. I never want things to be hard to understand, you know? Alright, we got the Cleric Strike. I didn't finish Bop, but I'm gonna look at a Shock Baton. Bug Smasher. Exterminate. I need a Kids Bop 12. I didn't put it. My brain. Glory. Trophy hunter. Multiple elements. So that should be MHP. ATK. times. 1.6. 5. SB dot DE. F. Alright, and exterminate, given by the Bug Smasher, deals more damage to insect enemies. Glory. All right. Exterminate. Deals more damage to insects. Deals damage based on strength. Deals more damage to insects. Rocket Hammer. Gator Smash Maul. Does anybody know of the Gator Smash Maul? Gator Smash? No ideas? I like Gator Smash. It's basically just kind of like a... like an inside joke between me and my mother. Because whenever we would play Champions of Norrath together... there is a weapon that you'd find all throughout the game called the Gator Smash Maul. And it was just fun to say. It was just a funny name. You know? Beep.
I don't know, man.
Maybe like one or two turns of increased critical. That's just the same thing I had before, you know? Charge. What to do with charge? I'll find out. Later. I'll find out later. Gator Smash Mall. Okay. Nope. No alarms. Yeah, no, it's great. It's great, right? I enjoy not having alarms. So I could just sleep in tomorrow. But I'm probably not. I'm probably going to be thinking about this all night while I'm trying to sleep. I'm going to sleep, and I'm going to see this. This is what I see whenever I dream. I have dreams of the database. And I feel like I'm like making such good progress. I'm making so many cool skills and items and stuff, and I've got all these great ideas. But it's not restful sleep, and whenever I wake up, I can't remember a single one of them, and it feels like I've just wasted all of my time. It's pretty great. Okay, let's see with the Dawnbreaker. Battle screen only. 5 minus B MDF plus B DEF. Sure, why not, right? Actually, no. No. Physical attack. Do divine damage based on magic and wisdom. Welcome back. Basic, just a divine damage move for hammer users that might not get one. So, actually, I think there's only 3 hammer users. Is that right? That can't be right. I got Laird can use hammers. Cian can use hammers. Dallow can use hammers. Huh. Really? That's kind of funny. Only 3 people can use hammers out of these characters. And 2 of them have built-in divine damage. And then I just made a hammer move for divine damage. That's okay. What? Are they onions? Garlic. We could totally make that a hidden weapon. The exclusive club. Or the Gentleman's Club. You can vaguely hear women dancing inside to music when you put your ear to the club. I had an idea. I'm gonna go with it. Gator Smash Mall! Once again, I ask, does anybody know about the Gator Smash Mall? The Gator Smash Mall. Shock Baton, I'm gonna get Paralysis. I gotta make the Pokemon Paralysis. Yeah, there you are. That works better. Well, it's just a big old hammer, right? So, me and my mother, We play a game called Champions of Norrath. I've talked about it a little bit. It's a PS2 game. Kind of top-down, isometric style. A little bit like Diablo, but not really. Because it's a little bit different. Way different. And a recurring weapon through the whole game, because you'll find it over and over and over again with better or worse stats, is the Gator Smash Maul. And it's just a big old two-handed hammer. That's it. It's not special in any way. It just has a funny name. And oops, I didn't mean to do that. And so I put the Gator Smash Maul in this game because I love it. And it's happy memories playing video games with me mammo. But this, I've got the perfect the perfect skill for this one. Wild Strike. I would love some toast. Just basic honey sounds good to me. Yes, thank you. She's so good to me. I don't know how to say that. Sit-up time again. All right, I'll be right back. Okay, so I want this to have a high variance. So it'll either do a lot more damage, like 100% more damage, or 100% less damage. Switching to my bed. I feel the burn. Okay, if I just said has a 90% damage variance, would you guys know what that meant? Would everyone know what that meant? So it's basically a gamble. Probably just make it basic damage, but it could do 90% more. Hmm. Damage can vary wildly. It's not as much information, you know, doesn't have the 90% number there, but you know, it should be able to tell the player, hey, you hit somebody with this, it could be way more damage or way less damage. Yes, please. Yeah, I'm good with that. Physical attack, so you could just miss. I don't have charge. I'm feeling a little... I don't know what the word is here. I'm feeling a little guilty.
Thank you.
It's for a very stupid reason. Sword skills get like 3 stances. Staves get 1. Hammer has 1 so far. Why do I feel guilty about that? I shouldn't feel guilty about that. Anyway, Twisted Mace. I have an idea for this one, too. It's gonna be... What's the word I'm looking for? Instead of it being describing the mace itself being a bat that just looks like it's been twisted, right? Like it's got grooves taken out and it's twisted. It's now got a twisted and sick personality. Sadistic strike. And I'll have to do this later as well, but... Alright, and this one will get progressively stronger the more it's used in battle, and then it'll reset at the end of battle. Blah, 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 blah. Thank you. Boop. I got my. Yeah, and some of them might not even get stances. Mmm, honey toast. What would you say that the specialty of the hammer is at the moment? Just big, big single target damage. Except for the cleric stance, which is the complete opposite. Which actually increases your healing abilities. Exterminate does more damage to insects. I never finished Bob. Bob. All right, you know what? I've used half my time on skills. I put mapping in the title, so we're gonna skip over to mapping, and I'm gonna try to finish this little area here that I started. Okay, so. School, front lawn. What toast? I didn't. Thank you, though. Okay, so point. Here's the start of the front lawn of the school. This is a terribly boring picture right here. Terribly boring. But I have no clue what I can do with it with my tiles here, you know? So I was kind of just going to go basic. Leave it basic and then try to come up with something at another time.
This is the gymnasium. And I'm actually, I don't know if I want this over here or over here, you know? Like, it could just be directly connected, or it could have, like, a small hallway. What if it rains? What do you mean? Yeah, a small way. So it'd probably have, like, a covering or something. Attached? I'm okay with that. It does, it does. This has only got, one area, though. No. No. Yeah, no. Now we can do that. You can't really see. Whoa, that's some thunder going on. I better save it. Better save that game. I might lose power. So if I just disappear, know that it's storming. Yeah, I couldn't give that heads up last night because I didn't even have a heads up. Okay, I want to talk about something here. Something that annoys the crap out of me. And that's the fact that you can't put fences going vertically near the edge. Because for some reason it likes to double it up. So it's supposed to look like that, but because it's next to the edge, it ends it like this. And it just bugs me. You know? Oops. As if it's doubled. It does it this way too, but it's harder to see. That's it. It just bugs me that I can't ever have areas right, like, fenced off next to the edge of the freaking map. Well, I could if I went to parallax mapping. But you know what? Mm.
It's okay. And the reason why is because I've gotten a little bit of... What's the word? Inspiration just now because of this. Sucks that this isn't the same color as this. I'd have to put it in and try to make it that color real quick. Usually it's still too sweet for me, though.
Yes. I just got full.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it was really
good,
though.
Oh, yeah. I'll do it. Thank you. Where'd I have it? I've got no... How do I... No, that doesn't work. Going to bed. All right, you know what? Gotta do it, I gotta do it. I gotta do it, I gotta do it, you know? Tile sets. And we'll be... Side alt. Gotta do what I gotta do it, you know? Here. All right, so at the moment I'm going to just...
Storm warning. On my phone.
Okay, so how does the gradient work with this? Custom. That's okay. I want to make it gradually, disappear, actually. So it'll just gradient from this to transparent. And I actually have no idea how to do that. I've never tried to do that before. I wonder if I can somehow make this into my color, into, like, if I could paint with this, you know? Make it into a brush of some sort. That way I could be like, oh, use this gradient. Anybody know how to do this? Image gradient. What does that mean? Whoa. 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 Set a